powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
You're welcome to this live transforming broadcast as we receive the engrafted word of God that is able to save our soul and empower us to become effective, productive in our God-given callings. I believe today we'll be receiving God's word that is going to help us take the lead. Let's look at Colossians 3 verse 1. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above. If ye then be risen with Christ, it's time to set our mind on the right things. You see, the condition of your mind has a lot to do with your faith in God. Yes, someone will say, how? If my mind is not renewed with God's word, I cannot be effective in my walk of faith. That was why Paul said, don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. The condition of my mind also determines how I respond to spiritual things. If I'm truly going to respond to spiritual things according to the will of God, then my mind has to be renewed in the knowledge of His will. And that becomes the foundation for right perspective. You know, some people view things from a perspective that is not consistent with God's word. The reason for that is unrenewed mind. A mind that is not renewed with the knowledge of the will of the Father. Because the mind is not renewed with the knowledge of the will of the Father, it becomes difficult for the person to function according to God's instruction. There are so many people today that said, I want to know the will of God for my life. I want to know what God wants me to do with my life. I want to know what God wants me to do about this job, about this finance, about this relationship. They're trying to know what God wants them to do. But the truth of it is this. If you are in Christ Jesus, if you are born again, Christ is already in you. And because He's already in you, He's willing to communicate His will to you if your mind is renewed according to His word. Unrenewed mind cannot tap into the will of God. It is impossible for a person whose mind is not renewed with the knowledge of the will of God to flow in the things of the Spirit. The reason for that is this. It takes revelation knowledge for faith to be activated. One of the ways we release our faith is when we have revelation knowledge of God's will. That was why when Paul was praying, he said that God will grant you spirit of wisdom and revelation in knowledge of Him. The reason for that is with revelation knowledge, we'll be able to think according to the will of God. With revelation knowledge, you'll be able to see things the way God wants us to see them. With revelation knowledge, you'll be able to speak the language of the Spirit and produce the God kind of result. So the condition of your mind is important in your spiritual development. And this is why it's important that we consistently feed our mind with God's word. You know, the soul is in James chapter 1, when James was writing, he said the soul will be saved by the engrafted word of God. The soul is made up of the will, the mind, and the emotion. He said the soul will be saved with the engrafted word of God. When you got born again, your spirit was saved and perfect. Your spirit was saved and perfect. But when we begin to renew our mind with God's word, we'll be sensitive to the voice of God. How do you become sensitive to His voice? How are you able to recognize the voice of God? It begins with the Word of God that you have heard, the Word of God you have read. You see, when you renew your mind with God's Word, you're quick to understand that this is the voice of God. This is the Holy Spirit talking, because you can know the will of God if you don't have a better knowledge of the written Word of God. It is difficult to relate with the Rhema word, with the spoken word, when you have no knowledge of the written word. When we have the knowledge of the written word, it equips us to understand when a word spoken can be said to be a Rhema word. Just that you heard a voice doesn't make it the voice of God. Just that you heard a word never made it the word of, doesn't make it the word of God. Because someone can say, the Lord spoke to me, and then you look at what they said that the Lord spoke to them, it is not consistent with the word of God. They say the Lord spoke to them, but what they are saying is not in line with His will. The written word will not disagree with the spoken word. Whenever God gives you a word, He will not contradict what He has said in the past. You know, God has a history of integrity, a history of great reputation. That simply means line upon line. If God has said it before, He adds something to it, and you check what He said in the past, is there's a connection, there is a link there that you can consider. Well, if He said this 5 years ago, He said this 6 years ago, He said this 10 years ago, and we can see consistency in His voice. God doesn't tell us they walk in holiness and tomorrow He endorses unrighteousness. That's not God. That is not His nature. His nature is in line with His will. He will never ask you to do something that contradicts what He has already established. So unrenewed mind cannot connect with the will of God. Unrenewed mind have the potential to doubt the integrity of God's word, to question the word of God. Can this really happen? Can that really happen? Because that mind is not renewed, it is difficult for it to flow in the things of the Spirit. The condition of your mind will also help in determining your spiritual condition. I said the condition of your mind will also lead in determining your spiritual condition. When we look at a person spiritually and say this person is not growing spiritually, you know what the problem is? It means they have not been renewing their mind with God's word. You know, when Joshua took over the leadership responsibility from Moses, one of the key things that God said to Joshua, he said, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth. He said, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but thou shalt meditate during day and night, and you will make your way prosperous. How is Joshua going to be prosperous? How is Joshua going to be great? How is Joshua going to be someone who is outstanding, someone who is influential, someone who is going to be powerful? It's when Joshua accepts the leadership responsibility, number one, and number two, when Joshua chooses to follow God's instruction concerning what He wants him to do. And for that instruction to be a reality, Joshua must be a person who is going to meditate on the word day and night. That was what He said to Joshua. He said, if you meditate on this Lord day and night, you will make your way prosperous. That simply means we'll become prosperous by getting involved, by getting ourselves involved into God's word. Like often I said to my listeners around the world, I said that meditation is the process of the digestion of the word of God into your spirit. When you meditate, you think about that scripture over and over, and suddenly revelation begins to come. Suddenly you begin to receive inspiration. You begin to receive insight, because God gives you revelation to empower you. God gives you revelation to strengthen you, and also God gives you revelation to inspire you to function from His will. The will of God is that we'll function from God's word. The will of God is that we'll do things that is in line with His will. The enemy will come with all kinds of distraction. You know, the purpose of distraction is to keep you off from your spiritual focus. The purpose of distraction is to keep you off from your spiritual focus. Maybe you're focusing on reading the word. You said, I'm going to read the book of Matthew this month. I'm going to read the book of Acts this week. Or I'm reading this, or I'm meditating on this scripture. And from nowhere, there is this distraction that showed up. And the essence of the distraction is to keep you away from the spiritual investment you are doing. You're making some spiritual investment when you read the word. was sharing one of our leaders yesterday. I said, whenever you're reading the word of God, you're making spiritual investment. Whenever you're speaking the word of God, you're investing spiritually. Whenever you speak God's word, you're making some spiritual investment. So the enemy comes to distract you. And let me say this to you. One of the ways we secure our focus is to stay connected to what God has called us to do. And that takes discipline. There is a place of spiritual discipline. If you are not disciplined spiritually, there are things you cannot achieve with God. Now, let's get back to that scripture we read for us in Colossians 3 verse 1. It said, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above. There are things you are called to seek. It says, seek those things which are above. If ye then be risen with Christ, it says, seek those things which is above. You see, your fellowship, your relationship with God should be your primary focus every day. I said, your relationship with God should be your primary focus every day. You see, if you don't consistently develop your walk with God, it will be difficult for you to flow in his plan for your life. God has a plan for your life. God has a plan for your potential. God has a plan for your gifting. God has a plan for the anointing on your life. And the only way this plan can become a reality is when you choose to spend time with God. And look at what he said here. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ seated on the right hand of God. He says, seek those things. Seek those things. Jesus gave us a very good picture of what to seek in Matthew 6 verse 33. And Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God, God's way of doing things. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, making his will your priority, and then all these things will be added to you. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. You see, God's way of doing things is actually the foundation for doing right things. You see, God's way of doing things is the foundation for doing right things. So he said, yeah, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which is above, and where Christ is seated on the right hand of God, and set your affection on the things above, not on the things on the earth. Does this mean we should not be effective when it comes to our business, to our career? No, it's just giving us a principle. This principle is based on priority. This is what it should be. This is the sequence of things. The kingdom, then your personal life. The kingdom, then your personal life. So the kingdom of God, if the kingdom of God takes the lead, it means you're going to be fruitful in every area of your life. When the kingdom takes the lead, I used to say to the people, if God's kingdom is not your priority, it will be difficult for you to stay and flow in the will of God. If God's kingdom is not your priority, it will be difficult for you to flow in the will of God. If the kingdom is not your priority, the kingdom has to be a priority for you to enjoy the will of God. There are a lot of people that think that God's will is boring. God's will is full of this and that. You know, they don't have a clear picture of what it means to walk with God. When a person receives a clear picture of what it means to walk with God, their way of thinking will change. Their expression will change. Their confession will change. Their attitude and approach towards God will change because they have a clarity of what the kingdom of God is all about. The kingdom is all about suffering, struggle, hardship, toiling, hard labor. Mm-mm. That's not what the kingdom of God is. In the scripture established in Romans, it said the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. When we know how to function in righteousness, we can manifest our dominion. When we know how to function in righteousness, nothing can be impossible to us. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, but peace, but joy in the Holy Ghost. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding. These are the manifestations of the nature of God in us. Righteousness, peace, and joy. These are the nature. These are the expression of his nature that we share in the kingdom. The day you got born again, you were made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You're made righteous not because of what you did. You are made righteous because of your confession towards the lordship of Jesus. He said that Jesus is the Lord of your life. That was how you became righteous. And righteousness is the the gift of God impacted into our human spirit. Righteousness is the gift of God. It's the ability to stand before God without a sense of guilt or inferiority. When you come into the knowledge of righteousness, it empowers you to overcome sin consciousness. Sin consciousness leads to condemnation. In Romans chapter 8, it said, therefore, there is no more condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. You know, we can't walk after the Spirit if we're not kingdom of God minded. We can't walk after the Spirit if we don't make God's word the foundation for our thinking. We can't walk after the Spirit when we don't choose the word of God as our standard for living. So for you to become a spiritually minded man, you have to be someone who have made the word of God the standard for your life. You know, often I say to people, your faith in God makes progress based on your ability to receive more of His word. I want to say that again. I said, your faith in God makes more progress based on your ability to receive more of His word. The scripture established in Romans 10:17. It says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So when I'm hearing the word of God, faith will be rising in my heart. And because faith will be rising, faith is rising in my heart, nothing can be impossible to me. Because faith is rising in my heart, nothing can be impossible to me. This is the key to effective living, to productive living. When you're hearing the word of God, so set your mind on those, on the right things, the things that pertaining to the kingdom of God. This is how you grow in your finances. God begins to give you strategy. God begins to give you insight. He begins to give you supernatural ideas. And suddenly you begin to realize what you should be doing concerning your ministry, concerning your business, concerning your call. And you're quick to walk in love. You're quick to forgive. You're quick to move on. You know, a lot of people, a lot of Christians find it difficult to forgive. A lot of Christians find it difficult to forgive. The reason is that most Christians that choose not the way of the Spirit will not be able to forgive, because you can't forgive in the flesh. In the flesh, you want to remember what they said to you, how they said it to you, and how they treated you. In the flesh, you want to remember all of those things they said to you. But when you become spiritually minded, number one, it means you're growing in your love walk. Number two, it means you are developing the peace of God that is within you. Number three, it means you're walking in the consciousness of your righteousness. If that is your reality, you know what happened? You're quick to forgive. You know, someone said something about you, they gossip you on Facebook or on Twitter, it's okay. It's okay. Well, Lord, well, thank you. And you're able to move on. But if you are in the flesh, that thing can eat you up. I'm telling you, it's gonna affect you. This is why to walk in the Spirit is the key to overcoming challenging situations. When you walk in the Spirit, when you walk in the Spirit that you know fulfill the lust of the flesh. This is the key to victory. This is the key to dominion. Those who walk in the flesh will not be able to overcome the activities of the enemy. You know why? The enemy will always screw them up. You always throw things at them, and when they throw it at them, because of the anger, the bitterness, the strife, the contention, they become slave to the enemy. The enemy start controlling them emotionally, mentally. You know what happened? Because they are not developing themselves to set their mind on those things that is on high, as they can flow in the will of God. It's time to set your mind on the right things. It's time to begin to renew your mind with God's word. It's time to begin to consider the thought that is going out of you. It's time to begin to reevaluate your mind and say, Lord, I want you to help me. I want you to search me to know wherever I'm not getting it right. Help me to get it right, Holy Spirit. Teach me your ways. Help me to flow in the things of the Spirit. I believe that the condition of your mind is a reflection of your spiritual condition. The condition of your mind is a reflection of your spiritual condition. Where you are spiritually will determine the quality of mind you're going to have. The scripture established in Philippians chapter 2 verse 5, it says, let this mind be in you that is in Christ Jesus. The mind of Christ is all we need to live the supernatural life and excel beyond every limitation, the natural, that may have the potential to hinder us. But because we have the mind of Christ, we'll rise above it. Learn to develop your mind. Learn to transform your mind with God's word and then expect uncommon success. If you're watching this broadcast today and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, it will be my pleasure to lead you to Christ today. And you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray this prayer with us, it makes you born again. And from this day forward, the Holy Spirit will begin to lead you. He will help you to be effective and productive in your calling. And also, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teachings on YouTube. It's Faithman Teachings on YouTube. When you subscribe, you're opportune to watch live transforming broadcasts that will inspire you to take the lead in the right direction. So you go subscribe to my YouTube channel, is Faithman Teachings on YouTube. And also, I want to encourage you to take advantage of my TV. It's called finishworktv.com. finishworktv is a ministry on the cutting edge that is changing the lives of people around the world. So go to finishworktv.com and watch live transforming teachings every day. It's going on 24/7, helping people around the world. So you go to Finish Up TV and watch live transforming broadcasts. And also, I want to encourage you to consider partnering with this ministry. You know, we consistently bring the Word of God to people, helping them to grow in their walk with God and to be effective in the kingdom. So you can partner with us by going to finishworktv.com. There is a place there where you can give with your MasterCard, Visa card, or Discovery. You can use your debit card or your credit card to be able to be a blessing. Whatever you are giving will be helping us to move the gospel forward in this generation. Thank you for being part of this broadcast. Also, you can get my new book on Amazon.com. 40 Things You Need to Know About Your Future is available on Amazon.com. 40 Things You Need to Know About Your Future is available on Amazon.com by Faithman Ogboada. So I encourage you to get that book. Don't ever forget this. There is greatness in you. Until my next broadcast, don't forget this also. Jesus is coming soon.